We think of California's Silicon Valley as the place where startup companies launch their high-tech dreams. But as Kelly Cobiella reports, there are signs of a new tech revolution in the works, half a world away in Afghanistan.
For decades, this valley has been known for little more than war. But take a closer look in Kabul today, and you'll see smartphones and tablets, laptops, and internet cafes. And tucked away in the city's dusty offices, you'll also find a small circle of 20-somethings dreaming of dot-com fortunes.
In our business, Google, Facebook, Twitter, they're our gods.
Mohammed Jafari is a 26-year-old marketing director and web designer for Tech Sharks, a startup building websites for Afghan companies.
We are building a digital world in Afghanistan. It's a digital world that connects Afghan people to other worlds.
They've designed websites for more than a dozen businesses, power companies, museums, retailers. And their own company has grown to 8 employees, including self-taught programmer and company founder Ahmed Reza Zahedi.
Are you profitable?
Yes.
Next year, higher profits?
Yes, of course.
Tech Sharks is on track to make $50,000 this year, a healthy profit in a country where a worker on average makes $425 a year.
It hasn't been easy. Business here is still done on a who-you-know basis. Only a quarter of adults are literate, and less than 5% have access to the internet.
And those connections are not exactly reliable. That hasn't stopped the creators of Hamrangi, a social networking site for Afghans only, the brainchild of 24-year-old Farhad Latif.
So this is our website.
He's brought in 4,200 users in 6 months. His goal, 1 million users, as more people connect to newly launched 3G networks and internet prices drop from a high of hundreds of dollars.
Now you can get an internet connection for 1,500 Afghanis, which is around $30. So, yes.
So that's much better than
yes,
it was.
Much better than it was. Yes, it's slow, but it works. It still works.
But these Afghan entrepreneurs face an even bigger challenge than connection speeds and literacy rates. Their success depends on stability after U.S. and coalition forces leave in 2014. Ali Reza Akbari is a computer programmer at Tech Sharks.
I feel bad about after 2014.
You're worried?
Yeah, I'm a little worried about that. But I hope for the bright future.
For now, they're working just like their Silicon Valley heroes, with a spare bedroom in the office for late nights, hoping the dot-com magic will rub off.
Why do you work so hard?
Because we are crazy. We have to, because we love our jobs. We do for our satisfactions, not just for the money. We work for the future, not for the present.
With two-thirds of the population under 25, these 20-somethings are Afghanistan's future. For CBS This Morning, Kelly Cobiella in Kabul.